Hey everyone, I'm back with another tutorial, and this one came from a student of mine. He was asking, what do all the symbols on the keyboard, what do all these symbols mean in English? Do you know what all these mean in English? Well, that's what we're going to talk about today. These are just keyboard keys. You know, your keyboard. Yeah? Everybody has one? I think if you have a computer, you probably have a keyboard. Unless if it broke. And then you have a broken keyboard. So anyway, yes, we're going to talk about basic keyboard symbols that you're going to find on your keyboard and how to say them in English and a little bit about what they mean. Okay? So here we go. Okay, knowing your keyboard in English means what do all these other symbols mean? I'm sure you know what A, B, C, D, E, F, G, all the ABCs. I know you probably know your numbers. What's above? What is this? What is that right there? Okay. So that's what we mean by knowing your keyboard. And if you're speaking English, you want to try to tell someone something and you don't know how to describe, like, what is this under the question mark? How do you say that? So that's what we're going to be talking today. And hopefully you find this informative, because we do live in an information age and you need to be able to tell people what you want. Okay? So, know your keyboard. Okay. Letters and numbers. I think everybody knows this, probably from English, but we'll just go over it really quick. You have, of course, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Some people say O, but this is O. If you say O, like 490, 23490, no. People were going to type this. That's a different. This is zero. Okay? Alright. There's a big argument in America about that. Okay. Our letters are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Okay? And they're all right here in the main working area of your keyboard. And when I say working area, is that's where all the letters are. Okay? That's your working area. Everything you type is going to be right here. Except for the occasional numbers, which are going to be up on top. And you may have a number keyboard on the side of yours, so it's the same thing. Okay, so the number line. Let's start with what's up here. That's what everybody wants to know. What the heck is all these things up here? Okay, this is called the number line. Everything here, where your numbers are. Okay. So we're going to start with this little thing in the corner on your number line, right next to number 1. Before the number 1, we have what's called a tilde. And usually that means about. For example, it's about 3 o'clock. So you would type, see if I can type here. I'm sorry. There we go. Okay. So you would say that it's about 3 o'clock p.m. Sorry. If I can type. There you go. Usually it means about 3 o'clock. And let's make that, oops, can we make that a little bigger for, put it up. And I'm having a little trouble, guys. Let's see, there you go. Okay. Okay, so it's about 3 o'clock. But the name is called tilde. Okay, the name is called tilde. The one underneath, the under the tilde, is called a backtick. A backtick. And it was meant for accents. If you want to put an accent on a word, you would use a backtick. But right now it's mostly used for computer programming. If you are a computer programmer, you'll use this quite a bit. Okay, so with the number one, here, let's go back on the number one, on the top of number one, okay, is exclamation mark. That means you want to show emotion, like, ah! Okay, something exciting. The next one above the number two is at. That means a location, like at gmail.com or at yahoo.com. I am giving you a location of where my email is. Okay? It's a location. Or meet me at Tom's house. Or meet me at some GPS coordinate on a map. Whatever. Okay. Number three. Above the number three, you have hash or pound. That's used to identify a decimal number. Okay? And so, not O-N-E. That is not a decimal number. Decimal numbers are 1, 2, 3. Okay? Not O-N-E-T-W-O-O-T-H-R-E. Okay? Not these. So, we need to identify that this is an actual decimal number. Okay? So the next one under number four is string or dollar sign. That has become because we need to identify money. And that's our money. US dollar, dollar sign. So, or we can say string. And in programming language, string means like a function of something. Some kind of function will have this in its name to be able to tell people that it is something, it is a function. Okay, number five. Number five, you're going to have percent or modulus. What a percent is below 100. Anything below 100%. 100%, we just say 1. Okay, or it might be modulus, which is the remainder of a division. For example, 9 divided by 7. Okay? 9 divided by 7 is what? Yeah, 1.2. Right. So it's going to give you 2. It'll say 2. Okay, if you use modulus, it's going to give you whatever is after the decimal point. Okay, whatever is after the decimal point. Okay, number 6 is exponent. And I think from, you remember your math class? Exponentials. Yeah, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. Okay, so you would simply write 2 exponent 4. Okay, it's a scientific notation. And it could also mean caret. Okay, again, computer programmers, we love to use word caret. Okay, identify something. I'm not a computer programmer. I try to, but right now, no time. Okay, so the next one is number 7. Above number 7, you have this symbol, and it means and. For example, this and that. This and that. Number 8 will have asterisk. Okay? Say it again. Asterisk. Yes. Or star or multiply. Because it can be used for you can be used for 8 times 8. And you can say that too. Okay? Or if you're using star, it means to increase the value of something. Okay? You want to increase its value. Like I say, yes! That means you're like really excited. Okay? So if you're typing something, use a star. It means like you're happy. You're really, really happy. Like, yes! Yes, yes, yes! Okay? So, to increase the value. Okay, here on number 9 and number 0. Number 9 and number 0, you have your open and close parentheses. As you see, I've been doing all this time, this and this and this and so on and so forth. Okay, open and close parentheses. This is opened, so I open my parentheses, I type what I want, and I close my parentheses. So, and it means to separate a statement. Make a separate statement inside of whatever you're typing. Okay? Here you have, let's see, next to number 0, you'll have the dashes. Okay? This one is an underline, underscore. Okay? Underline or underscore. It's basically like your teacher gives you fill in the blank. Okay, that's basically why it's there. And the next one is dash or hyphen, and that usually means to put words together like this in a train, like a train will be connected. Okay? Chicka 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 chicka. Okay? Put words together like a train. So anyway, you'll see that a lot if you're reading websites and things like that. So it just means to put two words together. Even if they don't belong together, you can put them together. Okay? Just put them together. Okay. This, of course, is addition. A plus B. I hope you know your math, because that's all I can say about it. Addition. Okay? Or it could mean plus. Okay? So. A plus B. Or A addition B. And our next one is equals. Or it could mean assignment. And what I mean by assignment is turtle is slow. I'm assigning a value of slow to turtle. Turtle is slow. Okay, it could mean assignment. Or it could mean equal. A plus B equals C. Okay, same thing. Assignment. You're saying it's equal to something. I'm saying the turtle is equal to being slow. Okay, so moving on, you're going to have, let's see, down, my keyboard's a little different. It's made in China. So we're my keyboard, I'm going to use this right here, okay? You might have it right here. Mine is up here next to the delete key, okay? I have a different keyboard. I'm sorry, if you can see. Let me see if I can hold it up for you. There you go. Can I find my finger? Okay. It's right next to the delete key, or it could be right there. Okay? Anyway. So, this one. Okay? Let's go back. Okay. Pipe. The up and down, it means to separate something. Okay? Separate, like a wall. Alright? Good. Bad. Yes. No. Whatever you want. Okay. And then we have backslash. And a long time ago, that meant a location identifier. If you're using Windows, that could mean C:\backslash. Okay. That is the location you are at on your computer. Or, I'm sorry, inside your computer. Okay. You are at this location. And that's basically, that's all your home row, your number line. All your number line symbols, okay? Those are your number lines. Now, we're going to continue on, and this I call the right side entry, because it's on the right side, and this is where you enter all your values, okay? Anything you need. So, we're going to start right here and right here, because they go hand in hand. These are called braces, okay? That's open brace, closed brace. Okay, so open and closed braces on the top here. And these are brackets, open and close brackets. Okay, again, this thing right here is called a pipe, and a backslash is your location on the computer. Okay, where are you on the computer? What directory are you in? It'll give you an identifier. It'll tell you where you are. Anyway, okay, so right next to the letter L here, we have two dots and a dot with a comma. Okay, so this is called a colon. Okay, a colon. And then here with one dot and a colon, we have a semicolon. Okay, a colon and a semicolon. And there are different grammatical uses for using both of them. I would encourage you to ask your grammar teacher how to use them. because it's a long story. English sucks sometimes because people have different meanings for things like that. Okay? Use this if you're going to say, like, if you're going to start a list, like A, B, C, D. Okay? If you're going to talk about something, use this if you're going to if you want to start a sentence inside of another sentence. That's the basic, I can understand it. Okay? If your grammar is really good, you'll start at one sentence inside of another describing something. Anyway, so this is basically, you're going to talk about, you need to bring the following items, colon, A, shirt, belt, shoes, you know, things like that. So anyway, if you're going to start a list, use colon. Okay, our next one are these two that look like the arrow keys, right? No, they're not the arrow keys. These are greater than or less than. Okay, these are math. Go to your math teacher. Say, what is this? What does this mean? Okay, that means greater than. I'm sorry, here you go. Greater than, and this means less than. I should reverse that. I'm sorry, guys. So we'll say less and slash. There you go. So you don't get from. I'm sorry. It's my mistake because I'm just typing this out. Okay, so less than, greater than. Okay? Less than, greater than. And this here under less than, you'll have a comma, which is a little flick of a pencil. Alright, pencil flick. And then you'll have a dot, and this means period. Okay? You want to stop a sentence, or you want to continue on a sentence. Make continuous sentence. Okay? Basically, this in English will mean that you want someone to stop just for a second, just for a little bit, and then continue on. Okay? Like, take a breath. Like okay, go. So, anyway. And the last one we have, question mark. Okay? The question mark means you are asking a question. And then underneath question mark, we have slash. Or it could mean or. Like you see I have over here. Less or greater than. Open or closed brace. Okay? It can mean its name is slash, or it could mean or. Either way. I don't know. Maybe I'm right or wrong about this, but that's what I say. And that's what I grew up typing, and that's what we say in America. So if you're from another country and you've heard someone else, let me know, because I'm always interested to know what some of these are in another language. And tell me in your language, okay? Tell me what these are in your language, so maybe I can learn something about you and your keyboard, okay? Anyway, if I'm wrong, I'm sorry. Tell me in the comments below, down there. Type, okay? Tell me. Bye-bye. And as always, thank you. Namaste. Bye-bye.